And what has been a theme much too often this season, the Slingers again shot poorly against the Saigon Heat last Sunday, dropping another winnable game, 75-73. The shots haven't been falling despite some excellent looks at the basket, as we see right here. Can they turn it around against the Kaohsiung Truth here today? Hang out and watch. And welcome once again to the ABL here on Hub Sports Arena, as we bring you another regular season matchup between the visiting Kaohsiung Truth and the second place hometown Singapore Slingers from right here at the OCBC Arena in the Lion City of Singapore. Well, both these teams are struggling at the moment. The Truth, after their heart-stopping win against the same Slingers on February the 19th, 79-75 on their court, have dropped three straight games, including a narrow loss to Singapore. Now, that was back on February 26th, the score 84-76. And most lately at the hand of the league-leading Hong Kong East Long Lions. That was just two nights ago, 89-75 in that contest. They've gone from a team that held down the fourth and final playoff spot to now the fifth-place roster. But all is not lost, and today has significant implications for this Kaohsiung Truth team, as you look at them being introduced right now here at the OCBC Center. The Slingers, until February the 5th, well, they were in charge of this league, and they've dropped four of their last six contests. Now remember, four of those losses have been by a total of 10 points, and three of those losses by two, so that just sort of accentuates the shooting woes that we were discussing earlier on. We look at these backup players for the Heat, or check that, the Kaohsiung Truth again with the record of five wins and 10 losses. Going against the Singapore Slingers, who are 11-6. So they have not shot the ball well from the perimeter, these Slingers, but to be fair, remember, they have not fielded a complete roster because of the injuries to Larry Liu, also Mitchell Folkoff, and most recently Justin Howard. Even last week, he was hampered a little bit, but turned in a stellar performance. 22 points, 25 boards for the big man, the heart and soul of these Singapore Slingers. And they are just about ready to be announced right now. There they are, red, white, Howard, the center right there. Really stoked for this game, as they do have a full complement of players. That there is the newest member of the Singapore Slingers. Josh Rufus Tonto, look for him to get a lot of playing time. Great basketball IQ, the 34-year-old veteran of the wars in the Philippines, played for the PBA for 8 years. Some of the other bench players, role players for the Singapore Slingers, Larry Liu, 23-year-old, 6'3 guard forward, also coming off an injury plagued season. Remember, he missed almost all of last season with an assortment of injuries. Ung Min Han right there. He's been a pleasant surprise. Mitchell Folkoff, he is back in the fold right now. He had a hamstring injury that sidelined him for 2 or 3 weeks. 5'11 guard, 27 years old, and probably one of the only true point guards on this team. Desmond O, 5'10 guard, 30 years of age, gets the start today. Defensive specialist. There's the X-Man, what a savior he's been for the Slingers this year. Last game, 27-point performance, 11 boards. A couple of weeks ago against the same Kaohsiung Truth team, he had a triple-double, single-handedly keeping the Slingers' head above water, so to speak. There is the man, Justin Howard, the 6'11 center, 35 years of age, leading the league in rebounds, 18-plus, averaging 22.5 points a game. He's third in the league there. And the Slingers need an awesome game from him today if they expect to win. The Kaohsiung Truth team that is desperate for a win. We'll talk more about that later here at the OCBC Arena. Chuck Schreiner with you, along with Frank Orsego, the national coach of Singapore. What a treat it is to have Frank back in his second tour here of Singapore. We'll be talking to him later. And let's check out what the coaches had to say before the game. And the standings first, Jay Wei, Leo Cedric Oliver, Wesley Hsu, and Derek Hall, the starters for the Kaohsiung Truth. The other side of the ball, Desmond O, Wong Wei Long, Xavier Alexander, Delvin Goh, Justin Howard, and now we will talk to the coaches and see what they had to comment on before the game today.
Well, I mean, we practice every day in shooting in the morning training, so I believe that today they'll basically come out and hope they can shoot well in the game. And but towards the end, it's the defensive end that we need to lock down their so-called penetration.
We've played each other three times now. This is going to be the fourth time. It's going to come down to effort and execution because both teams know each other pretty well at this point.
Well, I mean, actually, we are aiming for the first spot, but okay, at this moment, I don't think we got a chance to really catch up in the first one. But I'm pretty happy if at least a second in this after this game if we won. Yeah, but towards the end, I mean, game by game, we need to take care of our own business, right, and rely on other people.
We got to keep growing as a team. Chemistry-wise, we're still getting there each week because we're a brand new team. So. I mean, we're right there in the hunt, which is pretty good for the first year, and to have a chance this late, that's fun basketball. That's what everyone wants to see.
So looking at the team standings, Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions, well, they have done everything they needed to do to wrap up a title here in the ABL, 14-2, Singapore Slingers 11-6. Today would nail down second place for them and home court advantage against their opponent, whoever finishes third. Right now, it's the La Pilipinas at 9-8. What we were talking about, Saigon Heat, Kaohsiung Truth, and Westport Malaysia Dragons, throw a hat around all three of those teams. Any one of them could be that fourth and final playoff team. So great implications here for the Kaohsiung Truth. If they win today, they would get that sixth win that is so important to them. Remember, they've got two games left in the season as well. They will have to play. Talk about that a little bit later. They have a couple games, one against Saigon. Singapore Slingers will, they've got two games after today, and both of their games will be against Saigon. We're ready, getting ready for the tip-off right here again. Chuck Schreiner, along with you. Frank Borsego at my side. Frank, of this Singapore team, they haven't shot the ball very well in the last few weeks, but we sort of have the feeling that they're due for a rebound.
Yeah, I think you're right there, Chuck. I think sometimes, staying at the top of your game for the whole season can be challenging. And when you have a few setbacks and other people are called on to, come through for you. But I think, they've been training well this week. I think they're probably due for a good one.
On the other side of the ball, Derek Hall, number 33. Watch out for him. He's averaging over 20 points and 11 boards a game. And also Chris Oliver, the 6'7 forward, the 33-year-old averaging 20 points a game and 13 boards. So it's not like Kaohsiung is here without any talent. They have been in a lot of ball games that they have lost. This experience, as Coach Chen was talking about at the beginning of the show. And we'll see if they can put it all together right now. Singapore in white, Kaohsiung Truth in blue, and the ball controlled by Jay Wei, number 0. A little build up on the left-hand side. Now they swing it to the right. Cutting through will be number 2. That is Yuo. Back over to the left side, Jay Wei, around the screen and from behind. It's like a foul, little mix-up on defense there, Wong Wei Long with the hold. So first team foul of the game for the Slingers. And Kaohsiung Truth will take it out on the near sidelines there to inbound it, number 23, Chris Oliver. Swings it over to the left. Hall gives it up. He'll go to the high post. Oliver now, a little stutter step, turn, fires. Got it to roll, clanks it in, so 2-0. In favor of the Kaohsiung Truth, open it up here. Back comes Alexander, working on a fine two-game run. Screen there by Howard, he'll stay up top. There is Goh. Now the ball to Howard. Howard can hit that shot. 5 on the shot clock from the elbow. Wong gets it. That's a good sign, Frank. Last game, took a long time for Wong to get heated up. He hits his first shot. Maybe that'll be something for his confidence.
Yeah, I think it was good teamwork there by the Slingers. Everyone got a touch early.
Knocked away by Howard. His first block. He averages nearly 3 a game. Timing that one perfectly. Desmond O inside. The ball lost. Retrieved again by Howard. Looking through two players. Off to go. Nice, good recognition there by Alexander to feed go on the low block.
Yeah, yeah, nice teamwork by the Slingers there. Way to have good court vision to finish that off.
Oliver down at left side to Hall now, waiting for cutters. Back outside. Good perimeter defense by the Slingers. They're in a man-to-man set. A healthy man, Howard. Now he's with Oliver. Oliver, one on the shot clock, and the ball out of bounds. 24-second violation. Great interior defense by the Slingers.
Yeah, that was good. Good work. They've come out with a lot of energy. And I think their man-to-man, as Coach Neo mentioned earlier, is starting to get some rewards.
Howard, you said he could get that shot anywhere from around the free throw area. See, barely needs to leave his feet, so 6-2 lead for the Slingers. Slingers 3-3 from the floor. Oliver. Show and go move, long three back rim, rebound by Hall. Hall looking behind him, he'll take the ball himself, puts the baseline, good defense on the interior by Howard. Oliver switching to his left hand, gets the ball off. Back outside again, long three by two, right at the buzzer, count it for three, so 6-5. Wesley Sue averaging 9.6 a game. Alexander to Wong. Wong, there's the screen by Go. Desmond O, inside he goes to Alexander, bumps up against Howard. Little miscommunication there. Go picks it up as his pocket pick. Last touch by Singapore will be Kaohsiung's ball. So a little bit of confusion there on the interior offense that time by the Singapore Slingers. Their first turnover of the game. So one offense in that department.
Yeah, I think Kaohsiung's zone defense, the movement was much better. Didn't leave too many gaps for the Slingers to get through.
Hall, Oliver, he'll take that three and switch it. So first lead of the year, second lead of the game by Kaohsiung. They give up 87 points a game, Frank. They give up more points than any team in the league. Long three by Wong is going back to the side. So one and out for the Slingers, and back comes the truth. Ball in the hands of Oliver. Oliver, Go working on him. Back outside again. Sue again, and a reach-in foul. That'll go against Desmond. Oh, I think no. A blocking foul offensive.
Yeah, quite get there in time.
So Slingers, second turnover by the Kaohsiung Truth. Incidentally, the Slingers are the best defensive team in the league. They give up 74.5 points a game. That's music for your ears. I know, Frank, you are a big proponent of good defense on teams.
Yep. I think normally plays a great foundation for success every week.
Howard on the feed inside by Alexander. Easy two for him. He keeps Oliver off of him. Now it's Oliver from beyond the arc. Sue, two for two for downtown. So Singapore coming out to meet the perimeter shooters now. A little bit out of control. Oliver again, four on the shot clock. We'll have to shoot that one in. Second tray of the game for Oliver. So he's got six. Now a three-point lead, biggest lead of the game for Kaohsiung, as they have done most of their damage from downtown. Howard, Alexander, Go on the high post. Back outside, Wong around the screen. Inside he goes. Yep. Pop from the free throw line. Nice screen thrown there by Go.
Oh, very good. There's plenty of room in there for the Slingers to penetrate and pick up a high percentage shot.
One-point lead. Another three. Why not? Howard had it momentarily. Now Wong. He's off and running. Slingers ahead of him. Four on three. Ball picked off. Durant pass in the middle. Losing it momentarily is Oliver. Back to Yo. He'll turn and shoot is off the mark. Stepping in to get the rebound is Wong. His second rebound of the game. Back on the Slingers. Long pass downstairs and out of bounds it goes off the hands of Howard, who got tripped up in his own feet there momentarily. So here is a timeout on the court for Kaohsiung. They lead 11-10. Here is Oliver. There is Hall with the feed. Oliver from way downtown connects with the first of two. And got to get a hand in their face right there. You can see Go not close enough. Takes a step to his left, switches hands with the dribble, and just like that. So 9 of the 11 points for the Kaohsiung Truth, Frank, via the three-point shot.
Yeah. Well, I think you have to give them some credit. They've shared the ball around and got to people in open spaces, and they're obviously confident. You know, their go-to guys are really, you know, stepping up early, and so the Slingers will need to tighten up on that.
On the other side of the ball, Slingers doing a good job of passing the ball around, sharing the ball. We saw Wong get a couple of shots. He said that he's very much a finesse or very much a field-type shooter, and once he gets into a groove, I mean, he can hit four or five in a row, so we want to keep an eye on that. Plus, Howard looks like he's moving much better this week than he was last.
Yeah, definitely he's doing that. And the key thing is for Justin to keep his rebounding numbers up. That's going to be a big help in today's game.
Singapore Slingers, the second-best rebounding team in the ABL. They were first until a couple of weeks ago. Remember, then Howard suffering that injury, so that probably cost him a few boards. But back fully on the mend now. We talked to him before the game, and Justin reports that he is nearly 100% with that grade 2 turf toe. The ball now is way. Dribbles into a corner now around Oliver, looking for Hall. Hall with the ball, thought about it. Back outside again, three on the clock. Inside it goes. Shot there by Hall. So Kaohsiung doing a good job of running down the clock. 13-10 now. They lead by three. Checking into the game now for the Slingers. Number three, Urbis Dongo, a 6-1 guard, and another turnover. Oliver off to the races here. He's got Howard ahead of him. And underneath, no whistle there. Hall taking a spill. Foul, and that will go on number two, Luo. Otherwise, Alexander has an easy layup, so he will have to shoot from the line for two. There's a chance for the Slingers to get to within one. Wait a minute, is it a shooting foul? Let's watch it again. Here they are on the break. Oliver, you can see slight hesitation, knocked away by Queck, Leon Queck, who's checked into the game now. And very quickly the other way, Desmond Owen company. No, it is not a shooting foul. Queck gets it back outside to Urbis Tondo. Urbis Tondo swings it right. Alexander, post up move. Back outside again. Queck is wide open on the left. See if they get the ball to Alexander. They do, and Alexander gets a complete fill. So that'll tie it up. That is what was on the line, they say. So a 1-point lead, and another quick start so far by Xavier Alexander, Frank.
Yeah, that's excellent. That'll give him some confidence. Now, hopefully that might open up some driving lanes for him, getting some perimeter shots.
Talk about driving lanes. Jay Wade finding a lane right there. And again, down to five on the shot clock. Uo will take the long three, and we'll fill it up. So the 4-3 for Kaohsiung. They are on fire from beyond the arc. They lead by four, their biggest lead of the game, 16-12. Howard has that shot, and he will take that shot. Back rims that one, stepping into the lane, pick it off. There's number 33, Derek Hall, the 6'11 forward center. Gets it back. Oliver cuts inside. Alexander on him. Round one screen is Jose, who is in the game now. Raymar Jose, and the ball in the lane, knocked back. Nice play. Pick it up. Another foul. Alexander on his way to the basket. Did they give him the continuation? I believe they do. So, yes, count it. So 16-14 now. And Alexander a chance to get the Singapore to within one. You can see why there is a ball on the floor. Nice hustle play by Delvin Goh, getting it ahead of him. You can see the foul and the referee. Ooh, close call there, but they do give it to him. So count it and one.
Great hustle by Delvin.
Scoreboard here at the stadium still has 16-12. Now they have changed it. So Alexander, 4 points early on here. Off on the free throw, but great tip there by Queck, and Singapore will have another kick at the can, down by two, double team. Now the ball in the hands of Howard. Howard with the left hand now turns and fires. The jump hook is off the mark. Rebound taken by Hall. Back comes Truth. Lead pass. Oh, nice job hitting the trailer. Number 33, Hall, losing his man, so somebody missed a defensive assignment. So 18-14 matches the biggest lead of the game for the Truth. Alexander. Urbis Tondo, left hand, now the right. Skip pass back outside to go. Wide open, look for Urbis Tondo. He'll be off the mark, but stepping in. tipped that by Delvin Goh. Welcome play by Delvin.
Excellent work by Delvin. I think one of the key things for the Slingers to make some inroad is they do have to get those offensive rebounds against that zone.
That 2-3 zone we alluded to still being employed by the Kaohsiung crew. Kaohsiung thus far making their living from beyond the arc. That was a two there, jacked up by the lefty Raymond Jose off the mark. So 2-point lead now for the troops. 1:25 to go here in the first quarter. Give to Alexander, hesitation, up and in and one. Xavier Alexander off the feed. Great job drawing the contact in the air, retaining his balance, Frank, and at the line. We watch it again. There it is, the feed by Goh. Delvin Goh quietly having himself a nice game, Frank, here in the first quarter.
That's very nice. I think he's probably going to be one of the little X factors going forward towards the playoffs for the Slingers. And hopefully he will keep making those contributions.
Alexander with his second miss. Inside, beautiful feed, but missing the layup. Lead pass to Quet. Quet stops, pops, going to be off the mark. Difficult angle. Howard can't corral that one, and back from the truth. So opportunity going by the wayside for the Slingers. Quick ball movement there. Nice job by Alexander on the defensive end as Sue can't connect. There has been Tondo. Yep.
The Slingers are using a good ploy here. They're trying to push the ball up before the zone set up. Get some free ones.
First lead of the game for Singapore. It comes at the 35-second mark. Raymar Jose again gets it inside. Ball. Easy shot there, missed, but offensive board, the second one of the game for Kaohsiung. They ball swing the ball to the left. Now a six on the shot clock. Forces one up, popped away by Alexander. Good hustle by him. Lead pass to Howard. Foul! Can't finish it, so Justin will go to the line. Do it the conventional way, so almost the third time in the game, Singapore had an N1 situation. Not to be, as the ball wouldn't drop for him as we look at it again. Pass by Erzman Tondo, good pass. There, the contact by number three, Wong Sin Kai. 5'9 guard, the 33-year-old, averaging 5 points a game. So Howard gets the first one, the biggest lead of the game for Singapore. Well, Singapore, I have to be impressed with the first 10 minutes that they played, Frank, although the scoreboard shows a very close game. Like what they're doing in the half-court offense.
Yeah.
And in transition.
They're pushing the ball up, looking for those early opportunities.
Long three, way off mark. Let's see if they count that. I believe they do not. So Singapore will take the 22-18 lead at the end of the first quarter. We look at a couple of replays first. Singapore trail by as many as four, but end up with a four-point lead. Here's Alexander in the open court. Erzman Tondo, as we said, high off the glass, getting the roll that time. Another angle of it, and Oliver letting him go, didn't want to create the foul. And take a break here and be right back. 22-18 Slingers after the end of the first quarter.
All right, we're going to get into the 19 and shoot challenge. Get up the giant jersey, then come on
in. We're
good, yep. We're not, and Logan, focus as ever, all three going. 1, 2, 3, let's go!
OCBC Arena, Kaohsiung Truth against the hometown Singapore Slingers. The Slingers etching out a 22-18 lead here in the first quarter. Chuck Schreiner along with Frank Orsego. And Frank, you got to be happy with the Slingers in the half court game and in transition in that first quarter.
Yeah, definitely. I think they found a way to sort of like put some pressure on that zone, which started off really well. And, you know, they were able to get into the gaps and get some offensive rebounds to complement that work, which was really good. At the defensive end, you know, you've got to give a lot of credit to the Truth. You know, they shot the ball really well. And, you know, I think that will get a lot of respect from the Slingers going forward in the second quarter.
We'll have some first quarter statistics for you in just a minute. But Oliver had the hot hand for the Kaohsiung Truth, hitting three triples. They hit four total, so 12 of their 18 points coming from downtown. Slingers with the ball now in white. Wong Wei Long cuts through. Howard Alexander now playing the low post. Left hand dribble by Quek. Quek will rotate downstairs. Now Wong. Three! Well, we talked about Wong Wei Long and how streaky he is, Frank. That's his third bucket here in about 11 minutes of play, so he has it fired up at least in the early going here.
Yep, exactly.
Back to the basket is Oliver. Long three again. And that time off the mark. Snatched down by Howard. Slingers up by seven. Wong. Joe stays in the game. 2 points for him, but he gets some things off the ball. Another long three by Wong. And pushing the envelope a little bit too far that time. So one and out for the Slingers. Oliver with the ball. We look at stats in that first quarter. Slingers 10 of 14. That's the best they've shot the ball in a long time, Frank. 67%.
Very good.
Paul looking for cutters there. Nice defense by Alexander. Off balance shot there at the 24-second mark. Just getting it off. Inside. Paul now. Whip pass inside and a foul, and that'll go against Quek. The other side of the ball, 7 of 17 for Kaohsiung in that first quarter, 41%. But 4 of 8 from downtown, that's what accounted for most of the points that we talked about. The turnover categories, the Slingers committed 4 turnovers, also 4 for the Truth as well on the rebounding end of it. 8 rebounds for the Slingers, 1 O board, 7 for the Truth, 2 offensive board. Hall with a little
head run.
See that very often anymore. There you go. Quick left hand. Using his right shoulder to bend off the defender. So back up to a 7-point lead. Long three again off the mark. So starting to cool down the Truth from beyond the arc. Alexander ripping down the board. Inside ball knocked away, but a foul on Hall, and he protests. Howard says, come on, man. Is Coach Sabatino Chen, former University of Colorado basketball player, also University of Denver for 2 years there and 2 years as a Buffalo.
Nice.
Long thought about it. Looking for cutters again. Good. Alexander, a little turn inside again. What do we have here? 3 second violation on Howard, I believe. So another turnover, the fifth now for the Singapore Slingers. Watch it again here, the arrival of Howard, and you can see. He used to, as kids say, 1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, 3 Mississippi, and you better be out on the 3rd Mississippi. Oliver looking for cutters. Little lead pass inside, losing his defender, can't hit the layup, up again is Wei. Nice job of Wei, staying with it. Wong again, left hand pass around the horn. It goes Ung in the game. Alexander, a little jump step inside. Howard with the rebound, no. Hall, so 2 kicks a can for the Slingers, can't get it done. Quick pass, Hall. Big man turns it back outside to Oliver around the screen. Now to the left, to Wei. Wei right-handed dribble, Wong on him. Oliver loses it momentarily, gets it back. Hall, little show and go there, inside. 2 on the shot clock. There's a shot in and out of rims. Hall with the rebound. Up and in. Good job by Jarrett Hall. And the ball stolen away. Oliver over the outstretched hands of Howard. So Howard changing the shot. But yep. 6 turnovers now for Singapore. Wide open look for Ung. And 3. The second triple of the game for Singapore.
That's a good sign. for Harbin. He needs to make sure that he can have his feet set, finish that work.
He's had a couple of big games for the Slingers.
Yep.
Earlier on, away against the Hong Kong East Long Lions, he scored 23. Back comes Wong. Wong runs into number three, Wong Sin Kai. That'll be a foul on him. Two fouls now on Wong. Singapore will get the ball. Jaheim on the far sideline. Coach Neo liking what he's seen by his troops so far, and a very even effort by the Slingers. So far, Frank, this is the best they've looked really in their overall game, except for the turnovers, I guess, on the defensive end. Yep. But offensively, they seem to be in sync finally. Ong thought about it.
It's good. They're, you know, even point spread to start with. The assist count's up. So they're all positives to being able to handle this this zone. But they've got to look after the ball.
Wex throwing the ball away. That's seven turnovers for them. An ill-advised shot by Jay Way. And a foul. Now they're going to say it's a possession error, and that will go the way of the truth. Watch it again. Here's the replay. Getting tangled up with the ball there, Alexander and Hall. So far side taking it out. Now they say on the baseline. So inbound it will be Wong Sin Kai. Wong. Guarding the inbound pass. Oh boy, broken up very nicely there by Howard. The ball is on the floor. Lead pass by Alexander. Great job by Howard to steal the inbound pass. Olympic the ball ahead of Alexander for the dunk. 32-24. Biggest lead of the game for the Slingers, Frank.
Nice, nice. And they look their best when they lift that defensive intensity and they're able to run. I think that's probably going to be the key to the game, I think. Get those easy breakaway baskets. Don't let the truth set up that zone. And I think they'll be in good shape.
Timeout being called by the Kaohsiung truth. So what worked for the Kaohsiung in that first quarter is three-point shooting. And I think they've gone to the well once too often. I think they're going to have to get some more points off their half-court offense. In comparison, Singapore's half-court offense looking a little bit more effective than Kaohsiung in the early going.
Yeah, definitely. I think you're right for the chuck. And I think it shows that the Slingers have always played like that, share the ball around. They've got a good even point spread. That's a good sign for them to have a good outcome today.
Alexander has been carrying the team as of late. By the way, going back to first quarter statistics, Howard leading the Slingers, him and Alexander both with 6 points in fact. Long Way Long had four. Of course, he did another bucket, so he's got six now. On the other side of the ball, pretty much the Cedric Oliver show as he hit 3 of 7 from the floor in that first quarter. Yu with three, Hall with four, Sue with three. Remember, he hit the other triple for the Kaohsiung truth. So Slingers right now in the driver's seat. Remember, they won the last game here. Back on February 26, 84-76. But as Kaohsiung truth, as we said before, they need this game badly to stay in contention for that fourth and final playoff spot. And they've got the ball right now, so a lot to play for. Singapore, if they win today, they can nail down the second spot, which will give them home court advantage throughout the playoffs, at least against the third place team, whoever that might be. Right now, it's the Lob Pilipinas team. Oliver back outside. Hall with four on the shot clock. Still Hall. Post up. Back outside. Oliver lets it go. He did it. They're going to say a 24-second violation. So tough shutdown defense by the Slingers again, Frank.
That's it. That's I think that Coach Neo mentioned that at the start of the game. You know, he was very adamant that he wanted the defense to really create the game for them. And another great example.
Singapore Slingers always taking pride in their defense, and Ong taking pride in that shot from downtown. His second triple, he's got six. Singapore 11-point lead with 5 minutes to go here in the first half.
And that's the sort of confidence we want to see from Harbin out there. That'll really test that zone out.
Hall, Howard on him. Post up move. Right hand, hesitation, up, can't get it to ball. And a push, I believe, by, 3 second violation, they're going to say. A push on Howard. I think Oliver jawing with the ref.
think it was.
Let's watch it again. There's the push off right there by Oliver. So Wong. Still Wong. Now goes to the left hand. He's got Ung. He's got the hot hand camped on that left hand side. Back out it goes. Singapore going to run that half court offense again. Wong head down. Gets the ball forward to Howard. Howard on the other side of the court. Iran shot. Well, when it's going good, it's going good. Howard picks it off and up and in. Easy as you please. 37-24. Slingers by 13. Trying to force the ball inside, and it works for him. That was number zero, Jay Way, averaging 6.5 points a game. Howard. By the way, Larry Yu with that last shot. Howard sticking his outside shots. He's got 10. So two Slingers in double figures. Check that one. Alexander with 9 points. There's the pass. Baseline move and white shirts converging on the little man, Luo. Foul will go on Howard. So Singapore being very aggressive on the defensive end, Frank, and it shows. Look at this. Nice move to get free, but my goodness, three white shirts converge on him very, very quickly. Weak side help, and that's what you want to see if a coach. You love that weak side help on defense.
Exactly, Chuck. I think that sort of, I think it's sort of like setting the standard today for the Slingers.
Getting around one defender in a 24-second violation. The second one forced by the Slingers. Slingers playing out of their mind right now on defense.
Yep, fantastic. Coach Nero will be very happy with that. And I'm sure that that'll create a lot of indecision with the truth, Coach, as they go forward.
Coach Nero was saying before the game, it would be nice to have a game where it wasn't decided by one or two points.
Yeah, exactly.
This last month has been on needles and pins. Show and go. Over the arms of Howard was number two, Luo. 5'6 guard, smallest man on the court, the 25-year-old. Checking back into the game for the Slingers is Irvis Tongo. Oh, again. Well, when you've got the hot hand, you're going to get the ball. On Ben with his third triple of the game, Frank.
That's great. Great teamwork, great recognition there. And, that's. I think that shows a sign of maturity that comes for the Slingers when they're able to do that.
Paul with a little baby hook on the turn. It's the Taiwanese to within 12. Pass inside Howard. Alexander. Little jump. Oh, yes, inside. Beautiful move there by Vaughn. You can see two defenders coming out to him, and that's exactly what you do, what we were talking about, Frank. Yep. Once you start hitting your shots from outside, that forces the defenders to come out on the shooters, creating spaces in the interior.
Exactly, exactly.
On Ben with three triples, back outside again. Four on the shot clock, long three, again off the mark. Alexander ripping down the board. Back on the Slingers, four on four. And a foul reach in that time by Luo. That'll be three on him on the block. Three fouls already. Well, let's check out the three triples by Ung. We were singing his praises. There's the first one. Gets him off the mark. And then, yep, you're going to find him again. This time from the opposite side. Ung Han Bin knocking it down. And now for good measure on the left again. So three of four from downtown for Ung. He's got nine. Stepping through a triple team that time. A long three by Josh. That time is off the mark. 44-30. Jay Way inside and reaching in. Going on power. Doesn't agree with the call. With the hack. First foul on Justin. So no Slingers in foul trouble at all on the other side of the ball. We said Lou with three, Oliver with a pair. Coach Sabatini can't be liking what he's seen so far. A lot different than the last time the troops were here and they fought Singapore to a near standstill before succumbing 84-76. Hall around the screen. Oliver, now inside Hall, knocked away by Alexander. Now double team. Oliver with the three off the mark again. Offensive board by 32, Wesley Sue. We'll check that. Raymar Jose. Jose with the left hand. Little jump step on the interior. Popped up in the air. Howard comes down with it. Deep pass to Josh, who's been Tondo looking inside. Back out again. Rotates to the left. Wide open look for Folkoff, who's in the game. And he can't hit it. Mitch Folkoff, his first foray to the basket. Quickly, Kaohsiung, leaner inside, count it off the glass and in. Nice shot there by 13. That's Chang Hao Chung, his first bucket of the game.
Yeah, I think a couple of the truth players have come off the bench and given them a little spark where they were looking just a little sluggish earlier.
Folkoff, Josh, who's been Tondo inside and off the glass it goes. Didn't look like Howard was expecting that. So on the surface, it looked like a design play, but I think it caught Justin a little bit by surprise. So back come the truth. A little stutter step around Folkoff. Now they got a mismatch with Hall. Hall trying to work that one, turns and shoots, no good. 24-second violation. No, that will be the halftime. Check that, yes. So 44-32, Singapore having its way against the Kaohsiung Truth here in the first half. Very good job by the Slingers. We check out some replays again. There's in the lane. Bucket there by Wong Wei Long. Another one from Threesville. So everybody getting their hand in it. There's the lead pass, remember, off the steal. Alexander with the flush. So the Singapore Slingers in it. First half with a 44-32 lead when we return.
One of the hardest things in life is to be different. It's not easy to step out and do something that the next person is not doing.
You know, I grew up as a kid, you know, looking at the NBA, dreaming hopefully one day I can get there. I grew up watching All-Star games and, you know, thinking that'd be cool, you know, if I can make it there. And now I'm 11 years in consecutively, so you try not to take it for granted. You know, you understand that nothing is guaranteed to you. So I'm thankful.
Don't be afraid to be different, man. That's what Make Your Own Way stands for. Your way. Everybody is different. Everybody got a different story. You might be from the same block, you might be from the same park, the same neighborhood, whatever the case may be, but everybody got a different path.
I think what Dwayne and Li Ning are doing for these kids is unbelievable, man. I think we need more of those type of people that are not afraid to sacrifice something that's cool for something that can have a positive effect on so many others, and most importantly, a younger generation.
D-Wade coming to my high school, it means the greatest thing in the world, basically. And he's giving back to me, like this room, before he gave back to this room, it was really small. Now it just looks excellent, it looks the best. And D-Wade coming to my school, personally, that's just the greatest thing to ever happen, because most people, when they make it, they don't come back.
What these kids get to learn in these moments is not just how to put a ball in a hoop. They learn how to be themselves, be confident and confident in any arena. It's fun.
Make Your Own Way to me is kind of like paving your own path to greatness.
Be a leader, kind of follower.
To inspire other people to lead by example.
Challenging my team to find the need in the community, you know, without youth. And, you know, going around and trying to, you know, figure it out, man. And, you know, we always try to leave an impact. You know, every time we come to a city, I know how important that is. You know, it can be something small, man. Just by seeing someone come to your school or see someone care about you enough, it can change your whole outlook on life. You know, so I've been there before and I get it.
I'll work my ass out, but I still can't wait though. But I got just enough.
the Kaohsiung Truth at the end of the first half. Good game for Singapore, Frank. You know, we saw Singapore do a lot of things in their half-court game. Here are some highlights. Long three there, or that was a two after long two by Alexander. Now the other side of the ball. Not all one-way traffic. Yo with a long three that time. And for the first quarter at least, Kaohsiung Truth were kept in the game by their long-range shooting. Nice little pass there. Follow there. Look at that. Three. Delvin go for the Slingers. He had two, but he had a couple assists. Nice job in the open court. Look at that. Guy from the Slingers, Josh Erskine-Tondo. He had two in the first half. He's a wealth of experience from the PBA. And why not? You can be that open around the screen that time. Long way long. He had a couple of triples. Stutter step move by him. Gives it off to Oliver. Oliver, little mid-range jumper off the mark of Hall, right there to clean it up, up and in between two defenders. So Derek Hall, he's averaging 20.5 points. Hung in on. What a story he was in the first half. There's one of them right there. Not wasting any time when he gets the ball. There's the inbound right there. And watch Howard. He's going to give the pass to Alexander. Thank you very much. Singapore as they start taking charge. There's a clean up there on the face. This direction shot for the Howard. And things are going your way. They're going your way. Howard again. Now to Alexander right there. And he can hit that shot all day long. Justin Howard. So he's got 12 points here in the first half. Josh over the top there. Right there again. Sizing it up. A little catch and shoot action for Hung Min Hong. Here it is. Once again, finding the lane inside the little leaner. And that gets Kaohsiung Truth to within 12. So looking at the stats here, Singapore Slingers, 61%. That's the best they've shot, I believe, all season, 19 to 31. The other side of the ball, good defensive pressure by the Slingers, only in the Truth to 38%. 50% Slingers, 4 for 8, 4 for 15. After a hot start, they have cooled down. The Truth free throws, not really an issue. 17-16, neither are the rebounds. The turnovers, 8-7 in favor of the Truth. The assist, 11-6. Frank was talking about that. Singapore doing a great job of distributing the ball. Steals, 4-3. So, Frank Orsego, now the head coach of the Singapore national team and also the technical director of basketball operation for Singapore. Great to have you back in town, Frank. You've been here since July. You're working with the youngsters at the grassroots level as well as being in charge of the national team. And Frank, what do you see that's different this time around with the Slingers and the national team more directly now that you're here again?
It's great to be back, Chuck. It's really good to be back in Singapore and being involved in the basketball community. It's no question that I think the professionalism with the Slingers has gone a long way to creating a great environment for senior men's basketball here in Singapore. Obviously, the last two SEA Games campaigns, the national team's medaled with a bronze. And I really do believe the fact that these young men have had an opportunity to play professionally within the region, international competition, great day-to-day coaching and great and great support by the Basketball Association of Singapore to work together in partnership. And I hope that continues.
When you left last time, probably Singapore not really at the level that it is now. What reflections, we were talking a little bit about, but share with the audience the reflections that you have at this level, the Singapore Slingers, as to what they were before and what you see now.
Oh, okay. Well, when I arrived, it was an interesting time for the Singapore Slingers. It was mainly based with Australian athletes as they were playing in the Australian NBL in Australia, and then the exciting thing was for reasons were difficult to handle for the organisation, they weren't able to continue. And with that came an opportunity for a whole new league to develop. And then really there was the real birth of the Slingers, where the local content had a chance to step in. And I do fondly remember my first 2 years, because the first year was a major exhibition season, which was fantastic. And that really stamped the Singapore brand, I think, throughout the region. The Slinger brand was really looked at. And then after that, the opportunity to play the coach in the first season of the ABL. And, you know, we got to the semi-finals, and it was a great achievement. And probably our proudest moment was the fact that we had one local boy starting in every game for us. And I think that laid the foundation to what we have today.
Good stuff. And then also there is talk that the ABL might expand into to eight teams for next year, but that's, I guess, a question for further down the road. Your impressions of basketball in general in the Southeast Asian area, you're a native of Australia. Australia, a great basketball nation now, but just coming back again from the perspective of coming back a second time, what are your impressions of basketball in general in Southeast Asia?
Well, I think from my past experiences with basketball around the world, it's fantastic that we're able to have our own identity here. You know, we have our own style. We have our own evaluations with size. We play quick. Our players are aggressive in this region. There's no question that our better players can definitely shoot the three ball. And those are wonderful skills for us to be able to say, well, when you come to Southeast Asia, this is what you're going to be up against.
You are known as a coach that really emphasizes defensive pressure. We see that, your footprint all over with the Slingers. What led you to that? Why to you is defense so important in the grand scheme of things when you're developing a team?
Well, I think, you know, most coaches who have been around for a while and had some success, they would look back and say, you know, in the seasons where it really happened for us, we were able to stop teams from scoring. It just lays a great foundation for successful games. And so I think that if you have a bit of an off night, you can always lock some people down and make it a contest. And so it's always been fair to say that, you know, a lot of coaches say, hey, defense wins championships. And I think if you get it right, I think it does go a long way to helping.
Don't mean to put you on the spot here now, Frank, but predictions for the playoffs. The Slingers, it looks like that they're going to enter as the number two seeds. Well, what are your expectations for the Slingers as we head into the playoffs?
Well, there's two ways to look at it. You know, I'm sure they're probably a little bit disappointed that they haven't gotten all the way and locked down the number one seed. But the important thing is that they've never really been crushed by anyone. So that gives a great sign of how even the competition has been. For them, I think having a home semi-final series will be great for the fans. That will help, I hope, all going well, that they can move through to the championship series. And then after that, whoever they play, well, you know, who's to say? The one seed could get knocked out and then they could have the home series, the home final playoffs for the championship series. But Hong Kong, a pretty good team. It's going to take a great effort for someone to put them out. So, looking forward, I think they should go into the series with a lot of confidence. They've got a couple more games to really lift their momentum. I think the first half of this game, I think they've shown that, you know, if they go into this space, they're going to be around the mark, Chuck.
Some of the local players that that you have coached before, I know that you're very, very proud of. Can you just name one or two of them that you started out, so to speak, on this journey that you see them playing in front of the big guys now?
Well, you know, to be really... Wei Long and Desmond, they were two development players 6 years ago, just cutting their teeth, coming to training every day, and working really hard, and now they've become an integral part of the group. And you know, like when you look at Wei Long and his awards that he's won, and his ability to help the national team moving forward, you know, they're wonderful achievements. But outside of that, probably one of the things I'm really most proud of is the fact that my assistant coach, Coach Neo, was able to step up and be the head coach and be the face and be a local driving a professional team. I think that's probably one of the proudest things I'm really proud of.
We've been talking to Frank Osego, head coach of the Singapore national team and director of basketball operations here in Singapore, with his thoughts not only on the Slingers, basketball in general in Southeast Asia, but in particular in Singapore. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. 44-32 in favor of the Slingers here at the OCBC Arena. Thanks, Frank Orsego, my partner here for the day. Wise comments on basketball here, not only in Southeast Asia, but in Singapore in particular. Quest with the ball here. Baseline back outside. Alexander, long cross-court pass. And a foul. And if you believe Wong Wei Long is going to go to the line to shoot three. Well, Frank, they tell you don't foul the jump shooter.
That's right.
Basketball 101.
Yep.
A gentleman created that foul or made that foul. There he is right there, number zero. Long lights up the second one. Some halftime stats for you. You saw them on the screen. We'll get a little bit more particular here in a moment. He misses the third one. So 46-32, Singapore equaling their largest lead of the game. Oliver over to Wei. Wei, right side. Three blue shirts travel with him. Oh boy, really forcing at that time. Oliver. And late whistle there. They're going to say that Leon Kwek got him with the hand, I guess, or is it Ung? Watch it again. Here's the replay. A little bit out of control there. Oliver picking it up. And there is the foul by Leon Kwek, 6'2 guard, 20 years of age. Oliver with the first one. Oliver, as we said, part of that tandem. Him and Derek Hall averaging 20.5 points per game. In and out. Alexander with the rebound. Away go the Slingers. Wong. Inside move. Nice crisp passing by the Slingers. Quick bounce pass downstairs to Alexander. Back out they come. He wants a cutter. Kicks it back outside again. Ung for three. No good. Oohs and haws by the crowd. As he had three triples in the first half. Crowd obviously wanting another one. Wesley Sue. Off balance shot by him. Good defense by Ong, changing that shot. Alexander now. Still 2-3 zone being employed by Kaohsiung. Howard getting away from his man as Alexander. Howard with the shot, no good. Tip back outside again, and last touch by Singapore. So Coach Ngo trying to make sure that Singapore keeps that intensity. Not a real good possession for Singapore right there, Frank.
No. I think they did share the ball around, which is a positive. I just need a little bit more sharpness finishing off that shot.
Ball whipped around to Jay Wei. Wide open look for Hall, who knocks it down. Good job, good recognition to Hall right around the free throw line. With the lead trimmed to 11. This has been a bit of a problem for the Slingers from time to time this season. Getting the double-digit lead and then surrendering it. We saw that most emphatically in Hong Kong. Ball is going to be off, one and out. Remember when the Slingers had a 13-point lead with 2 minutes to go and somehow figured a way to surrender it. A little runner in the lane. Hall, no foul. Good defense by the Slingers in the interior. They stayed home and it paid off. Quick from the left side, off the mark. So Slingers, they shot 61% the first half. They have come back to earth with a thud here in the second.
Yeah. I think they need to share the ball around a little bit more, Chuck, and I think they got to get some penetration to the rim. I think this is where X needs to bring his talent to the group.
One and out. Hall misses that shot. Alexander hurrying the ball down the court, accelerates in the lane. Ung, nice ball movement. Wong from the left side, no good. So still come away with nothing. They're doing a good job of passing the ball, but nothing to show for it. A foul by Wong as he tried to front on Oliver and held on. So for Wong, second personal for him. Coach Ngo makes some changes here, checking into the game. Delvin Goh had a marvelous first half, the minutes that he played, also going off Leon Kwek. So Slingers will go big against the truth. give up a little speed for a little bit of
size.
Power, yeah, size. Alexander, last touch. That's 16 on the shot clock. Always tough for a team to keep consistently intense throughout a game. Singapore perhaps guilty of letting their foot off the pedal just a bit. Long three if it goes, and it does. Raymar Jose, averaging 10.2 a game, his first triple. Now a 9-point lead.
Sorry, Chuck, I think the thing that's going to concern Coach now is, they're working around their issues with their shooting, but, you know, he won't be happy that they've given up that easy scoring down the other end.
Alexander, still that 2-3 zone, long three again. So, Josh Urbitanto hitting his first three of the game. He's got five now, just what the doctor ordered for Singapore. Gets him off the snide. Oliver, inside look to Jose. Jose with the left hand turns, fires. Ball still in the air, knocked down. Stepping in the lane, it's Urbitanto. Still Urbitanto, and throws it away, gets it back. Inside look. Howard reverse. Great job by Wong to recognize Howard. Puts the ball right in his hands as it crosses from one side of the basket to the next. So 51-37, lead back up to 14. Jose missing the easy shot. Alexander stepping on the sideline, I think, is Josh Urbitanto, just when he was lining up to take the shot. So turnover for Singapore, stops the momentum. 5:45 to go here in the third quarter. With Oliver with the inbound. Chuck Schreiner, Frank Arcego, hoping you're enjoying your Sunday afternoon. Here's the OCBC Arena. A little turn and shoot, hesitation move in the air. So Raymar Jose making up for that miscue at the other end a little bit earlier. There's Urbitanto running the offense now. Down on the low block, switchy now. Is go. Alexander, Howard by the free throw line. Urbitanto thought about it. Left hand dribbles. He comes out. Three on the shot clock. Go. Turns, fires. Rebound fought for. On the floor again. I think last touch by who? Howard shaking his head, probably feeling that he should have corralled that ball much sooner. But Singapore will have the ball, but a timeout is going to be called by the Slingers. You can see quite clearly going off of Chris Oliver. So the Singapore ball, when we come back, 12-point lead for Singapore, but they cooled down just a little bit. A few mistakes on the offensive end, Frank, and those last two possessions by Singapore.
One of the positives, I think, out of that is it looked like they were lowering themselves back to this missing the shot sort of thing, but one of the great things that happened there, that Coach Nero was able to bring out a little bit more depth on the bench. You know, Josh came in, and they didn't have that in the last couple of weeks. So that those little things can just make a difference going forward.
Excellent point, and also the presence of Delvin Goh. He does, give you another dimension with that second big guy in there. Yes. And there's Howard with reverse on the play before that. We said great recognition. There's Urbitanto there, and look at that. Nice job putting it right in his hands. Momentum heading underneath the basket. Easy two, or the reverse for Mr. Howard, who now has 14 to lead all scorers for the Singapore Slingers. And he's just been a rock for the Slingers from day one. It's amazing, a 35-year-old. Now, I know he had the trouble with the turf toe where he missed a couple of games, but by and large, the last 2 years he's been here, Frank, hardly any injuries. And a lot of these games, he's playing 40 minutes.
I know. It's a testament to his, keeping himself in good shape. And obviously, he puts the work in on the track, and he's able to, deliver every day.
Urbitanto swings it over to Desmond Oh, who was checked into the game. Three on the shot clock. Shot is off the mark, and let's see who gets it. Rebound taken by Hall. Howard didn't want to foul. Now the ball in the hands of Wong. Wong still rotates to the right this time. Gets the ball to Hall, looking for cutters. Oliver sheds one defender. Back outside, 10 on the shot clock. Awkward looking pass there by Jose. Hall running it. Way off the mark there. Great defense there by Alexander, and he comes away with the ball.
Yeah, good one-on-one coverage by X. That's a good job.
Desmond O looking for Howard, who's being leaned on by Oliver. A little bit of a mismatch there. It's been Tonto, brings it back outside, swings it to O. O cutting through the lane. It's been Tonto now with the left hand. Four left on the shot clock. Long pass to Go. Go gets it, falls away with it, can't get it to Go. Good defensive stand there by the Truth, and back they come. Ball knocked away by Desmond O. He does so many things defensively for you. You were talking about how you value defense so much. You know, he does have limitations on offense, but boy, does he pay you back in dividends on the defensive end.
Yeah, that's right, Chuck. Like, you know, it's Coach Nero will always know that he'll get 100% on defensive end with Desmond. So, you know, when he's in, he'll know that he'll lock down and do a great job.
Howard. Oh, here's the shooter's roll, as they say. Yeah. Talking about hard work paying off sometimes. Strange how guys who try hard also get lucky.
Yep.
Back outside. Ball stolen by the X-Man, who comes away with it. Still him, and they're trailing up to two.
Well, there's a guy that works hard, Chuck.
That's right. Day in and day out, and that's why he's in the top seven in steals. 55-39. The Slingers up by 16, their largest lead of the game. And Coach Ngo has that satisfied look on his face. There it is again. Getting to the ball before Oliver. Seeing Quet, the trailer, with the finish, doing just what he's supposed to do. Follow the play. Don't try and do too much. Be there if he needs it.
Yep.
There he is, making himself available. Recognition by Alexander that he's got help. Quet delivering.
Fantastic. Good teamwork. And once again, it's that ability of the Slingers to be able to run out of defense and pick up those easy baskets. I don't think the Truth have had many opportunities like that today.
I'm going to ask you to turn on the devil's advocate, put on your coaching cap if you are Mr. Chen on the other side of the ball. What do you tell your team?
Well, you know, really, like when you're dealing with the Slingers, I think one of the most important things is being able to create a good open shot. I think, you know, they did that early in the game, and they were hot, and they were able to convert and got off to a good start. But the key thing is, obviously, if you're going to play a zone defense, you've got to get back and set it, Chuck. If you don't get back, you leave yourself open to easy baskets.
Excellent point, Frank. And Singapore, time and time again, has exploited that by getting the ball on turnovers or getting the ball very, very quickly behind the X-Man in transition, sort of poke holes in that 2-3 zone and then create spaces for themselves. Yeah. And Singapore has also helped itself by shooting pretty well.
Yeah, it's been a good day for them.
Full court pressure. Quick. Singapore pulls this out from time to time. Jay Way gives it up. A little bit of hesitation, so starting to have an effect. Quick doing a good job on number 13, Chang. Way again, back outside. Three on the shot clock. Oliver, off balance shot, no good. So the defensive pressure works. Desmond O in the open court is fouled. Let's see, that may be a flagrant. We'll see, that's on Chang. If it is, Singapore will get two and the ball. Desmond O pushing the ball, and there's the reach in. Whoa.
Let's see. Tough on the cold there, Chuck.
Yeah, so I don't think they're going to get the flagrant on that. So Singapore will get the ball on the near sidelines here, and a very reflective looking Chen at the moment. 2:45 to go here in the third quarter. It's been all Singapore. Howard will take that shot. One and out. Oliver strips the rebound. Back from the Truth. Hall with the high post gives it up. Nice to here we go. Blocked from behind by Howard. Quick. Opposite side. Howard again. Alexander. And again, they do not come out on the shooters. Whoa, little tip pass there. Inside and up and in. Desmond O.
Yep.
He has, you know, the 30-year-old, he's got a quick first step, exhibiting it right there, going around one defender in an acute angle, but still getting it to go, Frank.
Yep, yep. I think the Truth, their zone defense has started to spread a little bit too much, and I think the Slingers are really finding the gaps.
All on Howard, bumping and grinding. Howard will pop with a foul there by the other official. It's interesting to see the official that was right there didn't call the foul, but the official up near the free throw line calls it instead. So it is what it is, as they say. Hall will go to the line for two. 1:49 mark here in the third quarter at the OCBC Arena. If you just joined us, Singapore led by 14 at the half, and they haven't looked back. They lead by 17 now, and there's Derek Hall averaging 20.5 points a game at the line. Crowd about on one side, about two-thirds filled. Your view there is the opposite side. It's about half full. Maybe rainy weather here in Singapore, and today partly cloudy, so good weather to go outside. Oh boy, taking his eye off the ball, and that was a mistake there by Leon Kwek. Looked like he was looking for cutters. He was going to try and catch it and do a one-touch pass, but got to catch the ball first. Jay Way, Jose on the dribble. All measuring it up is off the mark, so outside shooting, the bane now of Kaohsiung. It was not that way in the first half. Howard knocks it down again from the free throw line. He can be lethal. 18-point lead, biggest lead of the game now for the Slingers. Entry pass, Hall again. A hold on foul, I believe that will go on Josh Urbiz-Tonto. Third team foul on the Slingers, and it comes at the 1:03 mark here in the third quarter. Fourth, excuse me. So next one goes down. Gibbs man gets a little bit of a blow now. Yep. Fans very appreciative of his effort. He has just been dynamite the last three games. Jose off balance shot. Howard grabs another rebound. Outlet to Urbiz-Tonto off the side. And last touch by Singapore, I believe. So, an errant pass by Urbiz-Tonto. That was a push, actually. Go on, Desmondo. So, turnover for Singapore. 18-point lead. Really no need for Singapore to act with such urgency, I don't think.
Yeah, I think that's probably, in some ways, that's probably Josh still finding his way with the group, you know, getting to know the guys. You know, he has a good feel for the game. He probably thought there might have been something there for the guys, maybe going for a 2-for-1, maybe, but didn't quite come off.
So that'll put Chang at the line for two. Singapore goes into the penalty. They're 15 foul, and this is the first one. Good look at Chen Hao Chung, 6-foot guard or forward, 23 years of age. He's averaging 4.5 points a game. Over two, so no harm, no foul, or no harm but a foul, I guess, for Singapore.
Yes.
Howard lurking on the low post, steps up. Desmondo, he is fouled. Desmond O, be very aggressive. I like to see that with Desmond. He does have a way. His dribble penetration skills are pretty much as good as anybody of the local guys on the team. Does a very good job. He can go to his left hand very efficiently, and from time to time he'll surprise you and squirm his way in between much taller players for an easy two.
Yep.
There he is right there, Desmond. Justin. There's been Tano lining it up. Free kill! 8 points now for the newest addition to the Singapore Slingers, Josh Urbiz-Tonto. You can see he's gaining confidence every step of the way.
Yep, Chuck. It's great. It's great for the Slingers to know that they've brought someone in like that.
Charging foul. So things, and right in the middle of it again, Desmond O. So somebody pushing off on him. Desmond may be slight, but it's a testament to his aggressiveness that he can get those sort of fouls. Oh boy, let's see if that's a foul. No, he can't get it off in time, so that will bring the end of the third quarter. Good third quarter for Desmond O and the Slingers as they take a 21-point lead. They lead 62-41. On the replay, the little give and go. Howard blocks it, and back the other way come the Slingers. There's Desmond getting through the trees. So they say getting the step on the taller policy measures the mismatch. And that will bring it to the end of the third quarter, 62-41. Slingers lead, 10 minutes to go here at the OCBC Arena. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. 10 more minutes to go. Chuck Schwein along with Frank Orsego. And Frank, Slinger is probably playing their best basketball of the afternoon there in that third quarter, stretching that 14-point half-time lead to 21.
Yeah. It's I think it's a little timely message to everyone in the competition that, you know, if they start pulling it all together, they're going to make a run at this. And But the proof will be in the pudding now, Chuck, if they can close this game out, because they've had a few fades of late.
Certainly have. We talked about the most famous one a little bit earlier on. Another three ball off the block. Steps through the trees and gets the rebound. Statistics after three quarters. The Slingers still shooting quite well. 26 of 48 for 54%. 6 of 13 from beyond the arc for 46%. Four offensive boards. 29 in total. 26 rebounds and four boards for the Truth. And look at it. Slowly. So things going from bad to worse for the Kaohsiung Truth. Let's get another look at it. And it looked like he just tripped and fell.
Yeah.
Traveling call, actually. Traveling call.
Yep.
So the other side of the ball, 34%. Seniors doing a good job on defense. Another miss by Hall. Taking nothing away from the Slingers defense, but the Truth has missed their share of gimmies.
Yep. I think they've worked hard. The Slingers are really trying to change some shots. They're competing with people at the basket. I think, they've got a little bit of size in there. It makes it tough. Just noticed a bit of a change up there with the Truth going to man, which is, something we haven't seen for a while. So see how that pans out.
They played the two previous games exclusively 2-3 zone, so coming out of their shell a bit, realizing that the Slingers are having a good night shooting up from the floor. That one's off the mark, however, by Quet. Double team there on the ball, last touch by Hu, Singapore, but nice job on the trap on the inbounds. Not on the inbounds, but on the rebound after the shot. Full court pressure by the Slingers once again. Hall. Get it across the half-court line. Still Hall looking for Oliver. Oliver setting it up, looking for cutters. There goes nine. Lynn cutting through. Now Hall on the baseline. The reverse is going to be off the mark. Good job by Howard to change that shot.
Yep.
Josh Uspintanto. Baseline. Travel. So another turnover for the Slingers. That's two in a row, and they certainly don't want to fritter away this lead. Truth do have a some good shooters on their side of the ball, and they can quickly cut into a lead if the Slingers are not careful. Carrying on with the turnovers now, and after three quarters, the Truth have 11, as do the Slingers. I like to see teams taking care of the ball a little bit better. Now there's Hall. Alexander is on him. Lead pass picked up by Alexander. Great reactions, anticipating that pass. Back on the X-Man, swings it over to Desmond. Desmond be very aggressive. Did he step on the end line? I guess he did, or is it a foul? No, he stepped on the baseline again.
Yep.
Wow.
Yep.
So three possessions, three turnovers for the Slingers. Again, full court pressure by Desmond Owen boys. Jay Way in the game now at the 7:59 mark. Wide open look for Oliver. And he was good miss in the first quarter. He couldn't hit since. Ball on the floor, Desmond Owen, last touch by the Slingers. So Desmond keeping up the pressure on the defensive end.
Yep. Well, they might not be putting it in the hole, Chuck, but at least the defensive intensity has been consistent today, and I think Coach Neo will be pretty happy with that.
Singapore, as we said before, are the leading defensive team in the league. They only give up 74.5 for getting away that time. Chang losing his defender in the process. No weak side help coming over to rescue. Quack. Bounce pass inside to Alexander. Alexander turns. Oh, beautiful move on the inside. Little cross step, losing his defender in the process.
Great skills there by X-Man, finishing that off.
Alexander now with 10. A foul at the other end. Singapore up by 21. Jay Way will check out. You're checking in for the Slingers, number 18, Mitch Volkoff. He's had his minutes eroded with the presence of Josh Erzman Tondo.
Yes, yeah. But also a really good performance today by Dezo. I think he's taken some minutes there as well.
Yes, he has. Oliver back outside. Chang, little show and go move, and a foul by, I believe that'll go on Mitch Volkoff. That'll be two on him. Well, next week the Slingers will take on the Saigon Heat in their last home game of the regular season, Frank. And
yes.
Saigon is a team on the rise.
Yes.
They beat Singapore right here last week in a thrilling game, 75-73. That game where Singapore only shot 33% from the floor. So you gotta hope that Singapore, you know, against a team like Saigon, they're going to have to shoot much better.
Yeah, definitely. And I think you know, we might be setting the standards for the playoffs to come, where people have to bring their A game if they want to move forward and have success this year.
Singapore, until February 5th, as we said, were the ruling the roost, so to speak, in the ABL. Shot by Wong is off the mark. Howard with an O-board. Yep, beautiful move, and good team. Sleep on defense was Oliver letting his man loose, and Alexander finding Howard. So back up to a 22-point lead now. Biggest lead, tying the biggest lead of the game for the Slingers. Now remember, if Singapore wins this game, Frank, there's no way the Ala Pilipinas team can catch them for second place, so Singapore will enjoy home court advantage should Pilipinas, in fact, be that third place team. Looks right now they might be. Alexander on the break. Can't get it to fall, but he will go the line for two. You know, looking at the X-Man's, he's only got 10 points, but I mean, you look at the other things that he does. Three steals. You know, he's got seven rebounds, one offensive board, a block. He just does everything on the court for you.
Looking at our last lot of stats there, Chuck,
nine assists
out of 20. You know, so that's one of the great things about the X-Men, his ability to change his game for what's really needed night in, night out. I think once Josh settles in, we might have an opportunity to see the X-Men come back and really deliver more on the points and really help drive the team home. But I think his ability to just bring different things to the game is a real credit to him.
Of course, one of his true mentors in the game right there, Michael Johnston, he can't say enough about it. He's always been high on the X-Man, and you know, he can sort of tell. I've had Michael tell me more than one time, watch for the X-Man tonight, he's gonna set it loose, and he said that to me just a couple weeks ago, and sure enough, the X-Man comes out 27 points, 10 boards, something like 20 assists, so a triple-double. Michael called that one right on the nose, so he seems to have his finger on the pulse of these teams. As we look at the team standings, Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions, well, they have wrapped up the league 14-2. Should Singapore win this game and go 12-6, it would be impossible for the Pilipinas to catch them, even should they win their, even if they finish it with identical 12 yep. and 8 records. Singapore, even though they both split games, Singapore has a point differential
yeah,
in
that's
that.
It.
So
yep.
Singapore
well
will be
the work there.
Will be the second place team, and they will have home court advantage should the Pilipinas. And it's no certain thing that the Pilipinas will get that third place spot, but should they get it, Singapore will have the two of the three games here at the OCBC Arena, which is good news.
Great for the fans.
Next man hits the first of two at the 6:08 mark. Coach Neal looking very content.
Yeah.
And, we were saying, you know, before the game, Frank, that it would be great if the Singapore's, not that this is a laugher, but it would be great if they could get a game where they didn't have to feel so frazzled at the end of the game, just yep. trying to push and tug to get the W. And
yep.
looks like
yep.
this might be just a recipe for them.
Yeah, that's right. Okay. You've got to be able to put teams away. And I think maybe today that third quarter really opened it up for them, and hopefully they're finding that little winning feeling.
So Singapore obviously with the 24-point lead in no hurry. They'll use up as much time as they can. Falkoff back outside to Wong, who's checked in the game, off the dribble, on the reverse. Oh, beautiful extension there by Quick. Leon Quick, one of the youngsters that I know you work with on a pretty much a weekly basis, had 10. He's been very, very consistent for the Slingers this year. Kind of yeah. a breakout season for him.
Yeah, it's fantastic. He struggled last year, had a had a bit of an illness that sort of like set his season back. But I know that
fever, I believe.
Yeah, and he had a wonderful preseason. Really did the work, and I think, you know, probably led by example, going away and really working on his game. So it's a real credit to him.
Only 20 years of age, so very much the face of future Singapore seniors basketball and the national team that you have intimate knowledge of.
Yeah, definitely. And we'd like to think that our Singaporean players one day will move to bigger things, and he has that potential.
Delvin go another one, only 21 years of age. I mean, it seems like he's been around forever, but no, remember when he came to the Slingers, he was only 17 or 18.
Yep.
So his game under your tutelage, Frank, and I'm not trying to patronize you at all, but his game has turned around 160 degrees since the last time we saw him last year. Still Alexander, he'll bring it back out. And what a heady basketball player.
Yep.
No need to hurry it, and off the foot. Leon Quick, well, we were just singing his praises.
Yeah. That's always the way it goes.
So the truth will come back. Under 5 minutes to play. Hall, subpar game by his standards for sure. Luo, Oliver, getting a hand there, and Hall, ooh, knocked away, and Alexander will get the foul, reaching in. 70-45, 25-point lead for the Slingers, and their defensive prowess has been on display today. As we said before, they only allow 74.5 points a game, the best in the league, but 45 points, what an effort.
That's a great effort. That's a great effort today.
Kaohsiung Truth, verge of a going 5-12 for them. Not necessarily by any means knock out totally the playoff picture, but this is a game that they really needed to win if they were going to keep pace with a very much improved Saigon Heat team.
Yep. Sorry.
Malaysia still in with a shout as well, so to speak. They have only won 5 games, but they've got two or three games to play. I think they're 5-13, so they've got 2 games to play. That would give them 7 if they win their next 2.
Yep.
So mathematically, they're still in it.
Yep.
As Larry Liu checks into the game.
Yeah, oh no, there's a couple of weeks to go, and there's still a lot of interest there. And those teams vying for that fourth spot, I think they could fight it out right through to the last week, Chuck.
Really impressed with the Saigon Heat last week against the Slingers, and in other games I've seen them play too. They could give any playoff team, including Hong Kong, a run for their money if they peak at the right time.
Yep, yep.
Wong lets it loose with about a second left on the shot clock. Misses, 4:13 to go. And Luo up and around shot, and somehow Wesley Su points to the heavens. Maybe was asking for divine intervention. His prayers were answered. So Liu, Volkov,
good.
shields himself and can't get it to fall. Alexander cleans it up though. Slingers will get another kick at the can. Falkoff puts the ball on the floor and off the glass, up and in. So Mitch on the board now, 72-49. With about 3.5 to go. So Kaohsiung playing out the string here. Singapore will win this game. I feel confident saying that. Another miss. Alexander, and that's what we don't want, I tell you. X-Man hitting the floor for about the fifth time this game. Let's look at it again. You hold your breath. I mean, Luo stepping in his path. Watch this. I mean, the score is 72-49, unless you're looking to strip the ball, but
he didn't look like he really made a
very dangerous
play.
Yeah. So let's see if maybe the X-Man, they give him a blow on the bench here. Chen, well, a little bit outmanned this game. Far cry from a couple weeks ago when they came here and gave Singapore all they would want.
Yep.
And remember when Howard went down, when Singapore went to their place, the Truth coming away with a 5-point win.
Yep.
But the Singapore not the same team. And headed towards the playoffs. Volkoff, the backup jumper, no good. Alexander comes up with the Howard lurking right there, and he'll take the shot. Howard with the rebound, rumbling towards the basket, gets the ball taken away, and Alexander gets a return back to Howard up and in. Crowd enjoy that, so does Howard. 74-49, 25-point bulge. Turn and shoot, and rattling it home is Derek Hall. Hall now with 15. Herb is Tonto in the game now. There he has the ball. Good first step, good recovery by Sue, and out of bounds it goes. Last touch by who? They're gonna say last touch by Kaohsiung with 2:11 to go here. So Alexander will exit the game, and very appreciative crowd. 12 points, not anywhere near his 19-point average, but he does so many other things. Look at the assist again in double figures.
Yeah, great all-round game. I think if you can bring that over the next few weeks, I think that it could lay the foundation for a great championship run for the Slingers.
Howard bullying his way in between two defenders. Go in the game now. Jose, and I guess they're gonna call go on that.
Delvin, he's like being one of the taller local boys, he's normally going head to head with either one of the imports or one of the frontline bigs. And I think he handles himself quite well for a young fella. It's all part of his development moving forward.
Well, Justin Howard will sit the last minute 49 to the appreciative applause of the fans as he exits. Checking in the game, a guy doesn't get much time. Ving Lun, 6-foot guard, 30 years of age, so can't really say he's necessarily big part of the future. Is he on the national team too, Ving Lun?
Oh, Ving Lun, yeah. He's coming this year as a development player. He's part of the group. So we've got some new faces with the national squad. Hopefully they'll continue to keep working in this space.
Josh jacks up a three, trying to pad his score line. He's got 8 off the dribble and. A bull in a china shop, but they're going to say a blocking foul, I guess, on Josh Erspin-Tondo. So he's got 3. Yeah, you see Josh trying real hard to modify his game, let's say. We know that the reputation of the PBA, very much a very fast-paced, up-and-down type of league, and then you come to, the ABL, not necessarily that type of a pace. And so he's having to change his game for the good of the team, and so he'll fit in with the Slingers. And you know, it's a process. It takes a little bit of time, but I think he's making great strides.
Yeah, that's right, Chuck. He's only been here a couple of weeks, and the reality of it all is, like, he has to actually fit in with the Slingers. Like, you know, they have a very team-oriented style. They like to share the ball around. Like, today is a great indication when you look at the point spread. And so that's a big adjustment, but it's always nice to know that he can put the foot on the floor and go, you know, and look at those skills.
Oohs and ahs as Ding Lun puts up a shot off the mark. They would have loved him to hit it. Sue with a long three. He had one the first half. Go with a rebound there, and we're under a minute to play in the Slingers. Very satisfying win in front of their home crowds after some bitter disappointments the last three or four weeks. Remember, they had lost four of their six games, but they've got everybody back and healthy now and on the same page. And Ding Lun again misses. Punched out. Go with his hands on it. Last touch by him. So it'll be Kaohsiung ball with 41.1 to go here.
There's no greater cry at the end of the game, Chuck, than when the benchie comes on and hits that shot.
Well, I can identify with that.
Yeah,
I lived used in to that be space. That guy.
Lived in that space.
Chang Hao Chung. Back outside. Chang again. A little acceleration off the dribble. Difficult shot there. And Go had it momentarily. Back outside it goes. 19 seconds to go. Off balance shot. 24 second violation. The Slingers will have the ball left with 15. So perfunctory now. The Slingers will inbound it. Play around with it. And that will be all she wrote here from the OCBC Arenas. The Singapore Slingers are going to get out of here with a very emphatic win against the very game, but overmatched, at least for today, Kaohsiung Truth. And that will be the game score, 76-52, the Slingers. So the air out of the balloon for the Kaohsiung Truth, and perhaps foreshadowing some good things to come, we hope, for the Singapore Slingers, who rise to 12-6 and nail down that second playoff position in the ABL, Frank.
Well, I think Coach Neo, we're really happy today, Chuck. I think he got the things that he really wanted. He wanted the team to be able to lock down on defense. The scoring didn't dry up in the later stages of the game, and they got the home court locked up. So I think tick all those three boxes.
Good point. The Slingers, who had a history, as we look at confirmation, the final score 76-52 over the Truth, had a history of sort of blowing big leads and having to scrape their way through in the dying moments, but not today. They kept their foot on the pedal. And we'll look at the play of the day. Here is the Slingers with Coach Ngo and the X-Man talking over there, savoring a very, very healthy win, 76-52. They feasted on the Truth today. We look at the play of the day. Hung Bin Han, he hit three triples. That is one of them. And that is our play of the day as he scores not one, not two. That is the second of three. All this in the first half, and the Slingers, remember, built that 14-point lead. Howard spotting Hong all alone, rushing to the outside shooter, and the 2-3 zone breaker was Ung Bin Han today, amongst others, and the Slingers very, very happy, and Ung right in the center of it. Why not? He was instrumental in that win. So the 2-3 zone finally comes to its end here at the OCBC Arena. As we look at the revised standings, Hong Kong Eastern Lions will win this league 14-2, but the Slingers 12-6, gratifying win for them. The Filipinas 9-8. Saigon Heat in control of fourth place for the moment at 6-10. Kaohsiung dropped to fifth. They're 5-12. Westport Malaysian Dragons in the cellar at the moment at 5-13. So next week, 15th of March, that's Wednesday, Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions. They're the league champions, going to get the always dangerous Saigon Heat. That will be in Hong Kong on StarHub on 8 o'clock on that evening, followed by on the 18th of March, Westport Malaysian Dragons against the same Kaohsiung Truth. That's on the 18th, and then following that, the game that we will be featuring here in Singapore at the same place, same time. The Singapore Slingers going against the Saigon Heat, 19th of March, next Sunday at 4 p.m., the Slingers' last regular season game. So we will wrap it up here from the OCBC Arena. Again, the final score, 76-52, the Slingers over the Kaohsiung Truth. For Frank Rosego, this is Chuck Schreiner and all of our production team. So long from Singapore.